the Avon-Maitland District School Board, literacy and numeracy resource teachers and curriculum coordinators partner with classroom teachers to engage in collaborative inquiry. They meet a minimum of half a day, once a week, from October to June. Curriculum support staff, classroom teachers, and their students come together to create a rich learning environment in which observation and reflection lead to a better understanding of the learning and teaching process. The following partnership took place in Carolyn Scaper's 567 classroom at Zurich Public School. We structured our learning around the iterative inquiry model of plan, act, observe, and reflect, which allowed us to immediately respond to student work and behavior. Our focus was accountable talk in collaborative structures. We began by observing our students working in various collaborative structures. They seemed engaged and respectful, but as we listened carefully, we realized students did not value the structures as purposeful beyond social interaction. Their conversations were superficial and short, and no single ideas were developed. The same students were always talking. After several days of observation, in which we recorded conversations and listened to student voice, we developed a theory of action that also aligned with the urgent learning need in the classroom. If students practice developing or stretching out their ideas through accountable talk, then their ability to develop their ideas in writing assignments will improve. The LNS monograph Grand Conversations in the Junior Classroom, A Guide to Effective Literacy Instruction, and Student Thinking guided us in developing the purpose and success criteria for accountable talk. Each skill then listed in the success criteria was explicitly taught. Our culminating event was a grand conversation with Eric Walters, a popular Canadian author of young adult novels.
Okay, we're really excited to have Eric Walters here today at Zurich Public School because this is a culminating activity for our students after 6 or 8 months of novel studies and reading the works of Eric. The kids have also been engaged in what we call grand conversations or accountable talk. They've been working with Louise Hoffman, who is a numeracy literacy teacher with our board, and also with Mrs. Scapers, the classroom teacher, to learn about how to have in-depth conversations to explore topics deeply and to discover lots about their own learning and make connections to other people's ideas as well, and to help them to understand just how much they've learned over the course of this year.
I think what you're trying to say is that David wasn't really wanting to have a babysitter at all at the start. He thought he could do that by himself, but then when the hurricane came and when the house started getting flooded, he wanted Elizabeth there with him.
In my book, my phone call, the high school was trashed with pork and ham, which is very, very insulting to Muslims.
I have a question. Why was it offensive to the Muslims?
Pork and pork products and doing pigs are considered the deepest insult Muslims want to eat pork or associate with pigs in any way. Different cultures have different insults.
Jordan, how did your character change in that book?
Well, his feelings have changed. Like there's two people, two main characters. One's angry, and then the other one, concerned.
Our next steps, if time had allowed, would be to observe how developing their ideas through accountable talk impacted their writing. The success of our collaborative inquiry partnership was based on a mutual trust between teachers, support staff, and the students. The supportive and safe culture in the classroom allowed us to question our practice, be creative in our response to student work and behavior, and communicate openly as a learning team.